Good morning, everybody. It's Saturday morning, okay? So this goes up like in an hour from now. I'll probably post it with another video because I'm behind about 10 days on my videos. And I really didn't want to make one because it's nice though right now. I was praying for a few hours today. And what I want you to see, let me give you an example. By the way, the officer that came to my house 2 weeks ago, now you listen to this. I have you on video, just listen. I have you on video entering this residence. Do you understand that? At 2 a.m, without a warrant, without cause. You're on video. You understand that, don't you? If you're watching this and you say, oh no, I better cover my ass. I better write everything. How would you like it if I said, listen to me. How would you like it if I said you sodomized me in my garage? You sodomized my daughter in my house. If I said that, which would be a false accusation. But I have enough history of cops following my ass for 2 years, pulling me over where my street friends, when I was trying to do recovery meetings with street guys, you pulled my ass over so much that the guys in the car said, they're pulling you over again. Cameron, when the cop pulled me over in Alice, this wasn't CCPD. But you listen, officer, that were in my residence. You wouldn't like it if I simply said, which has happened with another officer, not with me. My gay friends don't take this personal, but we refer to that as a sodomite. Do you understand that word? We refer to you as a sodomite. Now say if there seemed to be enough evidence, because I have you on video camera entering my residence. But it would be a false accusation if I said, you sodomized me. You sodomized my daughter in the garage. And I had her lie. Say if I was some young girl and I had a wicked mother who said, let's go for this, whether it's true or not. Because we use the system. And you would be outraged if I had you in this corrupt court with the DA who's been shown to be corrupt and your detectives who in the Guy Khan case, you would prefer to put that kid in prison for life. And you almost, I don't remember if you were seeking a death penalty on him because you could have called it capital murder. But you knew at Guy Khan, you knew at the end of that case, you guys effed up. You effed up because you knew you had the wrong kid. But in order to protect your image, you went ahead with that. Now, say if you were in a court, because there was enough evidence with the whole history. I'm sure you weren't aware of the history I have with you all, CCPD. But there was enough evidence simply showing you at my residence at 2 a.m, on video, which I still have, entering the residence, with the whole other documented history. I could have done that, but I would not do it. Why would I not do it? That would be a false accusation. So, I wouldn't do it. But what do you think these other people feel like? The guy Tom, I didn't see this rape case yesterday. This rape case that I've been commenting on, you should have never even brought a case like that to a trial. I have more evidence in the false story that I just showed you, the parable, what you would call this, the parable of a CCPD sodomite. Let me call it that. That way you'll have to watch the videos again. But integrity says you don't make false accusation. But what we have seen in this DA here, do you understand? Nelda, Mayor Nelda, Chad Miguel, I saw your face on TV yesterday. You know, there was an article, I'm getting killed by huge mosquitoes, giant, and I saw the CCPD. You have a cop in charge of vector control. What are you doing in the city? How much are you paying that guy? And you've got murders, rapes, bank robberies, and you got cops in charge of vector control. I worked in Kingsville for 25 years. We didn't have cops in charge of vector control. I knew the people in charge of everything. We didn't have cops in charge of the zoning and all. What are you doing? What are you doing in this city? Don't you know how to have resources and manage them? You could have somebody at half the salary in charge of vector control. Besides that, you're not even getting that job done. Because when you came out publicly last week after the boiled water fiasco, you then said the reason we're not spraying for mosquitoes is because we have this new system. I understand the system. You're putting the poison in the water. And as I sat here that week after I saw that, huge mosquitoes the size of, you know, bumblebees flying around here. Huge mosquitoes. And I thought, you're not killing the ones that are attacking everyone. Sure enough, yesterday in the paper, some guy wrote a letter to the editor in the Corpus Callum and said, some kids were getting off the bus. He said they were being attacked by mosquitoes. That's true. I left Bay Area Church Unlimited Sunday, and some lady had to pat my back down. She said, oh, you got about 100 mosquitoes. I kidded her. I said, oh, I won't charge you with assault and battery. She was killing the huge mosquitoes. And the guy wrote the letter to the editor and said, these kids were getting off the school bus and they were getting attacked. He went out with his can of off and walked the kids to the house. He said, they were being attacked. He said, please, save us. Do something. This is an absolute mismanagement disgrace, besides crimes that have been committed. Now, what this DA has done, the CCPD sodomite parable, what this DA has done is taken cases just like the scenario I gave you. Cases not whether or not the person was guilty, but whether or not we have enough to bring it forward. I'm shocked that you'd bring a rape case forward in this county where the woman's story is highly suspect. I see it from reading the paper. Even in her story, she has a reason why there's no semen, which is the key piece of evidence to bring a rape case. But the DA here and your detectives in the Gaetan case and others, you ain't looking for truth. You're not looking for truth. You understand? So, the officer that came here that day, you had no ill intent. I understand that. Why did you write John about the drive-by? And because it was true. It was true. Not that I believed that scenario. I was nice when you came. And that was it. I just, you know, I think it was a real drive-by. Well, it was a real drive-by. You came to my house. Those not familiar, about 3 weeks ago, a cop rang my bell at 2 in the morning. Said it was a drive-by shooting right here. Look, I lived in New Jersey my whole life, right by New York City, never had a drive-by, never heard guns going off. Here I hear gunshots going off left and right, drive-by shooting. And how could the cop, Lieutenant Hooper, say, we're not the most criminal city? Just from experience, I've never seen the likes of this. I've never seen the likes of this. I sit here at night sometimes, it's been a few weeks actually, but I hear guns. I kid you not, they're not hunting the doves either. These aren't pistols. We live by the water where people can shoot for doves. It's not even dove season. So that's what I want you to see. That's what I want you to see. And I'm sure you're grateful when you saw the title of this video. I'm sure you're grateful. And the other history of, I have friends in the street for many, many years. And some of my friends have relationships with an officer. This is not a lie. You have people that are gay, you have people that are straight, and everything. And I never made a big thing about that. But when I see the DA, with no evidence of semen, go through with the case, and some of my friends would have evidence of semen. Okay? You want to be graphic? These are friends of mine that have been on the streets for many years. And I don't know if any of them were ever forced cases of that act. But that happened because of sexual orientation. Okay? How do you know we're going to kill you, John? You know, you have threatened that. You guys really... You guys are something else. How did we do it? Would it make a difference if I had it on video? You have cops murdering people on video across this country. Lying, saying they went for my gun. What about that? You say, John, that case that I posted, it made it to Breitbart News. This week we also made it to Huffington Post. It was that cop that choked that girl, grabbed her phone. When that video went viral, the paper reports that Chief Simpson was in charge at the time. And they looked at the video, the cop, the Corpus cop, choking the girl that made it to YouTube viral video. It says he resigned. I wonder if he retired, which would mean after that was exposed, he basically got full pay. And if you retire, forget your name. You say, oh, well, that's done and over. You know what? I can push for you to, with the Justice Department, my friends, for them to push civil rights violation on you. What about them cops and detectives that lied in the death case of Carlos Saloon? What about the detectives that lied? This was in the Corpus paper. When you had the Guy Tom case, you went to the left. This was in the Corpus paper. This is public exposure of crimes committed by detectives. You said to Valent, he told you initially he did not ID any witness at that crime scene, the Gaetan case. You said, we know who did it, but we need a witness. And that man said to you, okay, I'll do it. 75% sure it was Gaetan. Then you went back to him. We need 100%. You committed a crime there. You suborned perjury. And that was public. What the DA has done, which we have seen in the courts here, that have been reported by the media, those are crimes. Official retaliation against prosecutors in your office. We have crimes, real ones, that have been shown by the DA and by cops. And the system in this city is if you walk into internal affairs and say, I was just sodomized by an officer, here's the semen. The internal affairs would say, we cannot do anything unless you press charges. And that person would be beat out of him by officers in the city. Because I gave you the case that you knew about. And how many that I don't know about? I'm sure by now, I'm hoping you finally interviewed Angel Hanley and Jesse, the common law husband. Not the other Jesse she used to be married to. Get it right. It's Jesse, who was the Iraq vet, the common law husband. I don't know Jesse. Try to get his last name, but I did meetings with you. By now, I'm hoping you finally investigated that. After 5 years of what you have done. So, to the officer that I have on video entering my residence, I'll be just. I think you just came by because you wanted to see if you could have seen who drove and did the drive-by. There was nothing done wrong. But imagine if I had a false accusation and you had such a corrupt DA that he wouldn't look at whether or not it was true. He would just think, you got him on video, John. You have a 5-year record of harassment that's been documented. we got us a case, let's do it. And I would say to Mr. Skirka, but it wasn't true. And Mr. Skirka would respond, we're not about truth. I have a voracious appetite as a glutton. So in order for me to keep my job, I will prosecute Mexicans left and right, knowing that they're innocent. And then you try, when you're on your way out of office, because the Democratic challenger to your office for district attorney, who has not guilty tattooed on his chest, has beat you in the primary. And listen, Justice Department, how long is it going to take before you to come and get these guys and put charges on them? Because this rape crime that's in court right now, today's date, it should have never made it to court. It should have never made it to court. And the way they operate here, we know this, is they have cases with no evidence where they realize the victim is the actual person being accused. And what they do, they did this with a Christian missionary by the name of Hannah Overton. They overcharge, and they say, we're going to charge you with capital murder or whatever. And what they probably did with this guy who they know is innocent of the rape, they probably said, because it's a couple of years before they brought this case to court, they probably said, I will do a plea, you know, you do 20 years in prison. And I'm sure the guy said, are you nuts? I didn't do it. And they overcharge. And what they say, because the judges here in this county, the ones that are just, the few that are just, have rebuked the DA. Because the DA has taken cases and gave the impression that they had evidence. And right then saying, plea, we have evidence, plea, we have evidence. And 1 hour before trial, they dropped the case. And the judges are getting pissed off here and saying, you're lying. You're abusing the system. That's what they do. So, for the CCPD sodomite parable, you just be gracious that I'm have the integrity to not do something like that. Because the DA here does not have that integrity. He's not looking at whether a crime is committed. He's looking at, oh, this looks good. This looks good, John. You got 5 years of proven harassment, and now you got a cop on video entering your residence. Say whatever you want, John. We don't really give a shit whether or not it's a true accusation, because we're just in it for our careers. Just be grateful that the citizens have integrity, because your corrupt system does not. Your corrupt system does not. This goes up in a few minutes. And bless my other friend. The Lord bless my friends, not the corrupt bastards. And keep my friends. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you. The Lord be gracious unto you. Your sons will be like plants grown up, and your daughters like polished cornerstones. Who will ascend the hill of the Lord? He that has clean hands and a pure heart. No man will able to stand before you all the days of your life. For they fought from heaven, the stars and their courses fought. Bless you, the Lord. Oh, you servants of the Lord, which by night stand in the house of the Lord. You know, I was reading in the Psalm, I should teach a few minutes here. And King David says, I've had a lot of prophetic signs these last few days. And King David says, if I were to count all of the wonderful thoughts and things that you have done, they are too innumerable for me to number. You know, there are times where my friend David Martin, was tried for murder, famous murder case. One day David said he had an experience. He was sitting in his car. He took Jackie, his girlfriend, to the hospital doctor appointment. And when she came out, David was in the car going, I can't, thank you, God, thank you, God, thank you, Jesus. He said, John, it was an experience where God began, if you will, downloading, this is how I would describe it, downloading revelation into him. And there were all these wonderful things. And he said it was almost too much to take. Do you know, sometimes, and the psalm that I just talked about, King David said, there are too innumerable, and I've had a lot of prophetic things happen the last couple of days. And there were some that were too many for me to say, wait a minute, it's going to take me time to see a lot of this. And that's when I thought of that verse, said, I can't number everything that's happening right now, and other things that you don't even know. I said, but we rest in God. Lead me to the rock that is higher than I am. Because all flesh is as grass, and all the flower of it, it's like things that are mowed. And David said, the same psalm David said, show us our days. Show us how short our life is. It is like nothing in your sight. David, King David in the Old Covenant, was walking in that kingdom. He was walking in that kingdom. He understood that everything down here is temporary. And everything, the scripture says in Hebrews, everything that can be shaken will be shaken. That the things cannot be shaken may remain. And for the CCPD officer, who may be in the beginning of this video when you saw the title, maybe before you realized it was just a parable, maybe there was, your heart was beating, and now you're grateful. Oh, grateful. What do you think the victims of these false prosecutions feel like? You knew Gaetan was innocent. You knew that. And you dissimulated, your detectives dissimulated to get false testimony. What do you think they feel like? Do you understand? I don't see how this DA, Skirka, could do any more prosecutions here. And I believe he's going to be, they're going to come and bring charges against him. Because it was so open. Those who are familiar with the courts, it was so open. You have corruption in this region that you do not know about. Okay? I posted the Patriot Dad site. He's got a WordPress blog. He showed that there's a possible organized child sex thing going on with officials here. And he showed some things on that. That's got a lot of hits because my daughter had Googled it. And that's a site that popped up. And he said there was a sheriff in this region, not Nueces. He gave the case. He said he was continually having sex with underage boys at the jail. I think it was Victoria. That was going on for years. Underground sex group. He got busted. And even when he got busted, but in all the cases that they were trying that had to do with child molestation, those judges were letting people off. And what this Patriot Dad guy said is, it's the possibilities because they were connected in these things. You have corruption in this part of the country that you do not have in other parts of the country. Okay? You have corruption here. You would not be able to see a DA get away with some of the things she's doing. And to bring a rape case, I have more evidence if I wanted to falsely accuse that officer than you have in that rape case. I have more of it because I have a history of harassment with the Corpus Christi Police Department. But I would not do it. It would be wrong to make a false accusation. Because those who lie in these things will be in hell very, very soon. Especially all the women that lie in these sex cases. God bless you.